And now we will learn about sales tax defaults for invoices. When do we actually owe the tax? Well, that's a question of cash versus accrual. You see, if we're on the accrual basis, it means the tax is owed when the invoice is made. However, if we're on the cash basis, the tax is owed when we actually get paid for the invoice. And if we only get a partial payment, that means part of the tax is owed. The tax that is owed will be proportional to the amount of the payment, and I'm going to show you in an example in this video. But for our first example, let's leave the default set as of invoice date. And now we'll enter this invoice. January 15 did 10 editing for Betty, and we made her invoice number 1. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. The date is back on January 15th. The customer is Betty, and the item is editing. And we did, let's take a look at the instructions, we did 10. So 10 editing for Betty, and the tax for 10 editing is $112. That's because Betty has New York State tax, 8%, and editing, 10 editing is 140, etc., etc. Now, when we click Save and Close, we can look at the Sales Tax Liability Report. Don't forget to push A for all. And we look at the New York State tax, the total that we owe to New York. We can double click, and we can see that this last invoice on January 15th added the full amount of tax for that invoice, $112. When we double click, we can see the invoice, and there is no indication that we got paid. This proves that QuickBooks declares that we owe the tax at the moment that we make the invoice. Now, let's actually go and change the default to upon receipt of payment. From the main menu, click Edit, Preferences. The category of preference to choose is sales tax. Then click the Company Preference tab. In the bottom left, where it says, when do you owe sales tax, click upon receipt of payment, cash basis. Now click OK, and now let's take a look at the next example. And now that the preference has changed, let's take a look at this example. Imagine January 16 did 20 editing hours for Betty. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. The date is January 16th. The customer is Betty. The item is editing, and both the customer and the item are taxable. Now, after we put in the quantity and push tab, we see that there is $224 owed to New York State for this particular invoice. But look what happens after we click Save and Close. From the main menu, click Vendors, Sales Tax Liability Report, and push A for all. Notice New York State sales tax did not change. When we double click the total that we owe as of January 16th to New York State, we see that the invoice for January 16th is not even listed in the report. That's because we changed the defaults and none of the sales tax is owed because we only made the invoice and we did not yet receive payment. You may also notice that the invoice dated January 15th that was here a moment ago is gone. That's because the defaults were changed, and if the money has not been paid on the invoice, it means the tax is not owed for the previous invoice either. And now let's see what happens when we get paid for that invoice. Imagine on January 17, we received $1,400 from Betty for the January 16th invoice, which is about half the invoice service amount. From the main menu, click Customers, Receive Payment. The date that we received payment was January 17th. The customer paid cash, and the customer who paid was Betty. Now, we received $1,400, push tab, and QuickBooks applies it to the oldest invoice. Let's click the check mark in the margin to remove how it's applied, scroll all the way down, and let's apply it to the January 16th invoice the way the instructions asked us to do. We click the check mark in the margin, and you'll notice the entire $1,400 is applied only to the invoice on January 16th. Now, that's about half the service amount, and it's about a little bit less than half of the invoice. Click Save and Close, and now we'll again open our sales tax liability report. Ha ha! The New York State tax has increased after receiving payment for that invoice. And when we double click, we can look here at the bottom and we can see for the January 17th payment, which relates to the January 16th invoice, $103 of what was paid relates to the sales tax and is proportional. If we double click, we go back to the invoice and you can see the total amount of tax was $224. We paid about half the invoice, so this is a little bit less than half the tax. That's because the tax amount changes the balance of the invoice. So this is the amount of sales tax owed. Again, even though $224 was owed, since a little bit less than half the invoice is paid, only a little bit less of the actual tax is owed. Sometimes even very good students will ask, why is the sales tax payable account in the trial balance different from the sales tax liability report regarding the amount owed? Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. Don't forget to push A for All on your keyboard to make sure the pull-down menu choice is All. Now, right now it says sales tax payable $1,068.80. But wait a minute. If I open the vendor, sales tax, liability report, and also push A for All, it says the total tax owed, or tax collected, which is really the amount owed, is $836.50. Now, I have explained in a previous video that the total owed to each tax agency altogether must be equal to the liability account and the trial balance, sales tax payable. So why is it different? Well, I'll tell you. It's because we have to change the trial balance from accrual basis, which is what it's showing now, to cash basis, which is what we change the sales tax report over to when we change the default. So right now, the sales tax report is showing under the cash basis, but the trial balance is showing under accrual basis. But if we change the trial balance to be the same as the sales tax liability report, if they're both showing the cash basis, then they should show the same number. Here's our sales tax liability report, and when we click Customize Report, we can see that it's already under the cash basis. That's because we changed the preferences at the beginning of the video. However, when we look at the trial balance and we click Customize Report, we see the trial balance is under the accrual basis. If we click to change it to the cash basis and then click OK, aha! Sales tax payable in the trial balance is now $836.50, which is the same as the total owed on the sales tax liability report, $836.50.